Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Myah and this is Inspired by Myah. What? Spider? What? So in today's video, I'm going to be making these ruched pants by jadedldn. And I think they look so cool and I think, yeah, they look sick. So I'm going to be making them in blue. I'm on a little bit of a tight schedule again, just like in my last video, because I want to wear these pants tomorrow and they're still in pieces because I had a bit of a mare, to be honest. Like, I ordered the cotton tape for the ruching in like this. Okay, I clicked turquoise. I don't know why I clicked turquoise, because the fabric is not turquoise. You'll see in a bit. Well, it was way off and I just didn't think it'd be that bad. So I ended up having to send that back and wait for a new one to come. But now it's all come and I've only got one day to sew it. So it's gonna be a little bit of a fast-paced video. Maybe not for you, but for me it's gonna be fast-paced. Anyways, I feel like I'm rambling, so let's just get on into the video. So here are my pattern pieces. This is the back and this is the front. I've got two of the back and two of the front. The pattern is so long because we're ruching. I had to extend the leg so that it has enough fabric to gather. So yeah, that's the back, and then on the front it's in two parts because in the jadedldn version there's a split at the knee, so I've done that, which I'll show you how I'm gonna do later. But it's really simple, to be honest. There's not a lot of pattern pieces to it. The only other thing that would probably differ is a waistband, but I've decided not to do a waistband and I'm just gonna put the elastic in when I hem the top of the pants, if that makes sense. But again, you'll see that. So the first thing that I'm gonna do on all of my pieces is just overlock all around them, literally every single piece, because I want open seams since I need to use my seam allowance to make the ruching channels. So I started overlocking every single pattern piece I had with my overlocker. I'm using white thread because I don't have any blue overlocking thread, but even if I did, I don't think I would have changed it because it's so long to thread up. After I finished overlocking all my pieces, I matched the two back pieces and two front pieces right sides facing and sewed the crotch seam with a straight stitch. Next, I started to work on the knee split feature. So to do this, we're going to partially sew the seam. So I placed the pieces right sides facing on top of each other and sewed in 2 centimeters on both sides of the leg. Make sure you do a back stitch at the start and end of your stitch so that it doesn't come undone. After that, I took my pieces to the iron and ironed the crotch seam open and then did the same to the knee so that the part of the seam that wasn't sewn is folded flat like it would be sewn. Then I just did a box stitch around that seam. For detailing purposes, I lengthened my stitch to in between 3 and 4 and then did a straight stitch about 8 to 9 millimeters away from the edge. You will have to do a pivot stitch for this, where you leave your needle in the fabric when you reach the corner, then you lift the foot and pivot the fabric around to the position you need it in. I also went ahead and did another top stitch about 2 to 3 millimeters in from the previous stitch. The trick to getting your pants looking really professional is all in the details and precision when sewing. My tip is to try and get your top stitching to land directly on top of the overlocking so that when you look on the inside you can barely see the top stitch. Next, I just gave it another iron. Now we can start putting the front and back of the pants together. So I placed them right sides facing and pinned along the outside of the pants, only because we still need to access the inside of the pants to add the ruching channels. Instead of using 1 centimeter here in the pattern, I added 1.5 centimeters so that I have space for the string to thread into the channels. But this seam felt like forever because the legs were so long. After that was over, I pressed open the seams to make it easier for the next step, which was sewing the ruching channels. So at this point, I realized a seam gauge and foot would be really ideal for this, but I didn't have one, so I definitely need to invest in one. But for now, I had to make do with another foot with a wider base, so I just used my zipper foot. I played with the width of the needle and adjusted it so that when I sew, the stitch is around 1.3 to 1.4 centimeters away from the seam. After doing my first one, I looked at it and noticed I missed a few spots and the fabric didn't get sewn down, so I had to fix that. So I ended up deciding to just sew it from the wrong side to limit my mistakes because I'm picking.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Okay, so now that I've sewn my channels for the ruching, I'm ready to add the ties in, but I didn't calculate properly how to do this, so it's not gonna be how I wanted it to be. Basically, I was planning to do a buttonhole and then thread it through, but I should have done the buttonhole before I closed these down, basically, because if I do buttonhole, it's just gonna go straight through to the other side and there's nowhere for the ruching to go in, if that makes sense. But basically what I'm gonna have to do is just seam rip with my seam ripper two holes for the ruching to go in and out. And then I'm also gonna have to make use of some cotton tape to get the loop so that the ruching can come through and wrap around something. I hope that makes sense. So what I've done is I've just marked where I want to put the tape and where I'm gonna seam rip. So at the bottom, my hem is like 5 centimeters. So I've just measured 3 centimeters up, and that's where I'm gonna stitch the cotton tape in place. So I'm just gonna stitch on both sides and then also down the middle so that I've got a loop for the tape to wrap through. But obviously we need to seam rip on the inside of the seam allowance, not all the way through the pant, at the bottom there, and that's the same on the other leg. And then at the top, this is where the seam ripping's gonna be, on the outside, because on the picture the ties are on the outside and you can visibly see it. So this bit's gonna get seam ripped right here so that the ties can get pulled through. And that, I've measured that down, I think it was, yeah, 3 centimeters from this slit in the knee. And then again, up above, I've measured 3 centimeters. That's where another cotton tape is gonna go. And again, from the top of the pant, I've just measured down 20.5 centimeters on both sides and done a little stitch. And this is where it's gonna get seam ripped on the outside seam allowance, so that we can pull the ties through. I hope this makes sense. Maybe it'll be a bit more clearer when I'm doing it, but that's what I'm gonna do now. Now I was almost at the end, so I need to add in the straps for the ruching. And to do this, I just placed the tape along the length of the section of ruching, doubled it, and added around 20 centimeters extra so that there's a nice amount of tape for tying. Then I threaded the blue tape through the channels. To do this, I attached a paper clip to the end of the tape and pushed it through the hole on the good side of the fabric and worked my way to the cotton tape area so that I could loop it around and bring it back up to the top on the outside of the trouser. Now for the tedious bit, I needed to gather the inseam of the trouser. There's two ways to go about doing this, but you can use the same method we used for the outside of the leg with the adjustable ruching, or you can gather the trouser legs to your fixed length, which is what I did because I was trying to follow the inspo a bit more. So I just went ahead and set my stitch length to the longest setting and sewed a gathering stitch on the inside of the legs. Remember not to backstitch because we need to pull on them. Once that was all done, I took out a pair of wide leg jeans that fit my length and gathered the inseam until it matched my pair of jeans. Also, I didn't start my stitch too close to the crotch area because I thought it might not look that good, and also at the bottom of the pants because we still needed space to hem them. To be honest, after finishing it, I think I would have preferred to have adjustable straps on the inseam because I made mine a bit too long, and to fix it I needed to hem it again. But a good reason for the adjustable straps is that it allows the pant to fit a wider range of leg lengths, which is something that I think is really good about this design. I left a bit of extra length at the bottom, but this proved unnecessary because, as I explained earlier, it became too long. After I gathered all four of the sides of the inseam, I made sure that the slots in the knee would be at the same position on both sides and that the crotch seam matched up. And then I pinned it all together and sewed along it with a straight stitch. Another thing I would make differently here is that I wouldn't have overlocked the inseam because it makes it really bulky after the gathering. So in the future, I would just overlock it after gathering it. Now everything is basically done. We just need to hem the waist and the bottom of the pants. So I folded my waistband down to the line I marked, which was 5 centimeters, and then marked where I need to make the buttonholes for the pull string at the waist. After I did that, I cut a small piece of interfacing and ironed it onto the back of that area. I also did the same to the bottom of the trousers. And whilst I was at it, I ironed the rest of the waistband down to make it easier to sew. Next, I needed to do the buttonholes, so I made two buttonholes around 12 to 13 millimeters wide and 1.5 centimeters away from the center front. Then I carefully seam ripped them open. Then I just sewed the waist closed with a straight stitch, but left a gap big enough for me to thread the elastic through the waist. Before I continued with the waistband, I sewed up the bottom of the pants with a straight stitch as well. Now back to the waistband. I took a piece of elastic that was 5 centimeters wide and measured it around my mid-high waist. Next, I just attached a paper clip to the end of the elastic and threaded it through the waistband. And when I reached the hole again, I pulled the elastic through and placed it on top of the other end and sewed it down with multiple zigzag stitches because you don't want it to come undone. Then I just pulled on the waist to even out the gathers. And make sure before you close the waistband up that your elastic is not twisted inside the waistband because that would be a nightmare. Then I finished up the waistband by completing the rest of the waist stitch. Now I'm gonna do a jogging bottom style waistband, which is really easy to do. All you need to do is stretch as you top stitch the waistband down. Just make sure that your stitches are evenly sewn away from the previous one. I did my first one at 1 centimeter, I think, and then I changed the width of my needle so that it sewed further away from the last stitch. But to keep it straight, I matched the edge of the foot up with the last stitch. Make sure that you leave a big enough width around the buttonholes for your cotton tape to go through around the waist. Now, I didn't record this, but I threaded a piece of tape through the waistband using a paper clip, and the pants were finally complete. So here's the final reveal. The end of the video, guys. I really hope that you enjoyed watching this video. These pants were so fun to make. Like, I know, to be honest, they were quite smooth sailing as well. The only problem that I had was with me forgetting to do the buttonhole before the seam, which when I explain that part, I hope that you understood. Yeah, also I want to say that the pants are inspired by jadedldn, but I made them a little bit slimmer. Now, it wasn't really on purpose, but I also kind of like it, but I also wish it was a bit wider, but again, I think the slimmer kind of fit complements my figure a bit more, but that's the only thing that I would say is a bit off from the inspired photo, and to fix that you just widen the pant leg, you know what I mean? Other than that, I think the pants are really cool. I got about 10 meters of the cotton tape and that was just about enough. So I'm quite lucky because when I brought the first one, I only ordered 6 meters, but I had to send it back because it was the wrong color, like really wrong. Yeah, so it's good that that all happened, otherwise I would have been short. Yeah, the pants are really comfortable as well. The waistband is just elastic waistbands. They fit so nicely. The length, I made mine a little bit too long. You know, when I left that about 4 or 5 centimeters at the bottom, like when I was wearing them, they kept dragging on the floor and I was slipping on them. So I'm gonna hem it again. Or you can ruche up the sides a bit more, but it starts to look a bit funky if you do it too much. So I'm just gonna hem it again. Overall, I did get a lot of compliments on the pants, which was kind of nice. Like, thanks guys. But yeah, I love them. That's all I got to say really. And they're really easy to make. So if you do make them or recreate them, please let me know. Tag me on Instagram at inspiredbymyah.uk. And also maybe follow my TikTok. I'm not that active on it, but I'm trying to be. Eventually, I'll get into a little flow. And please, if you haven't already, like this video, comment what you think of the trousers, and subscribe. Turn on my post notifications as well, so you know every time I upload a video, which is every month, usually on a Friday. So, yeah, I think that's everything. So, enjoy the rest of your day, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.